สวัสดีครับ
So today we'll be submitting a video explaining about our ship design for fluid mechanics. So basically, I'll start with how ships stay afloat. There are two main concepts about this. The first one is the buoyancy force and stability. I won't be going into deep about this. I have friends for that. And now I'll have my friend explain about buoyancy.
Now I will explain to you about buoyancy first. So when we have somebody is immersed in the fluid and the outward front is exerted by the fluid on the surface. The outward force is equal to the weight of the fluid displaced by the body, and we call it the buoyancy front.
Did you know what is stability? The criteria by any direction from steady motion tends to decrease. A given time of steady motion is stable. If the ship will return to that state of motion after a disband without intervention by the captain. A ship has three axes about which stability is defined with three associated degree of freedom angle, normal displacement, and change of velocity. See artificial, stability, and control.
So in the next part, we are going to talk about why did the Titanic sink, which in this topic, we are going to adapt it to our ship. There's four possible arguments that why Titanic sink. The first one, the wall that's separating the bulkhead only has a few feet above the waterline. The next one is a steel plate were joined by reverse hammer in by hand. In that day, they're using the welding process to build up the ship, so the strength of the nails and joint is not strong enough to resist the force that's going to happen. The third one is about the communication when the emergency event happened on the ship. And the fourth is the Titanic has a double bottom but not a double hull, which is the most important because if we have the ship, this is the front side of the ship. The Titanic has only the double bottom, which is like this. But if we want it to become the double hull, it should cover all the wall and the hull like this. So next, we are going to talk about what is make our ship different.
After you understand all the concepts that's needed to keep the ship afloat, this is our ship itself. The diagram is not, this picture is not really what it'll look like, it's just an approximation. So basically here's the ship itself. Now, the two differences we can see right away is that, first things first, this is the double hull system, where we basically have two layers of the hull itself, not unlike the Titanic, where the Titanic only has a single hull with a double bottom, but we have a double hull with a double bottom. So now you can see here's the waterline around this part. Now, the problem with Titanic is that the walls, like I think you heard it before, now the difference is our walls that separate each bulkhead is much higher, and we did a simulation. Now we don't have the video, but now it's here. So the simulation showed that when there is a breach in the hull, now the breach won't be as bad because we have a double hull. And the next part is that the water will never exceed the walls that separate the bulkhead. So it will stay within the compartments that is supposed to be filled with water. Now in the case that the ship will sink, it won't be sunk in the way that where it got broken into two pieces due to the too much of a load that happened over here. We will have a system that will eject all the bottom compartments, and the ship itself will become a new one where it's a much smaller one, and all these towers on top that act as a smoke funnel, these will be retractable and become much more short. This ship itself will be the smaller, it's like the ship inside this one where we retract all the bottom compartments, so it'll be floating or sinking, up to you. And we have a ballast tank that will rapidly fill itself with water from both the front and back in the case that the ship pitches forward or backwards, so it will re-stabilize itself. And on the side, we have retractable skids made of a tube shape filled with air. So the skids are like helicopter skids, it just helps the ship from rocking left and right. Now, this is pretty much how our ship will work. This will not sink at all. And now this is the overall design. It will not sink. If it does, no one will die.